would jihad be justified on the liberation of Kashmir? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam spent 13 years in Mecca, oppressed, with no jihad. The only time he waged war was when he reached the Medina and they attacked him. Only then did Allah give permission. أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِأَنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُوا. Allah now give permission for them to fight. And you cannot wage war, Kashmir cannot wage war with the Indian army. Kashmir will be destroyed in minutes. India is a nuclear power. So how are you going to wage war? You have to wait for the Great War. It is only after the Great War that Medina will no longer be kharab. At this time, Medina is kharab. You know what I'm talking about? Umranu Bayt al-Maqdis, kharabu Yathrib. That when Jerusalem is center stage in the world, Medina will be in forlorn desolation. Kharabu Yathrib, khuruj al-Malhama. The next step, the next thing to occur will be the Great War, which is now coming. Millions will die. The Jews want the war because they believe that both sides will destroy each other. And after the Malhama, Israel will rule the world. But that's not going to happen. After the Khuruj al-Malhama, only then will the world of Islam rise, not before. Fathul Constantinia. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam praised the army and he praised the commander. So the world of Islam is going to rise up after the Great War, not before.